So the answer no is something that we cannot obtain in finite time. And that is why the halting problem is called semi-decidable, because we can kind of decide half of the answers. And it's also called undecidable because we cannot output a clear yes or no after a finite amount of time. Why this nitpicking? What's the difference, you may ask? The interest of this is, of course, rather theoretic, but semi-decidable problems have a very interesting property called recursive enumerability. Now, that sounds a bit strange. What does that mean? Recursive enumerability means that you can write a program that outputs all combinations of inputs and programs, and I really seriously mean all combinations of inputs and programs that halt. So this program here cannot say for any input and program that this combination will not halt, but it can output a complete list of combinations of inputs and programs that will halt. So let's have a look at this program. And of course, this program runs on infinitely. So it starts out by defining a length called max length to be 0. And then it goes into an infinite loop, which is this one here. And what it does then is it increases max length by 1 each time it goes into this loop here, enumerates all programs of length at most max length. Now, if you fix this max length here, there is a huge number of programs that have a length at most max length, but it's finite. It's huge, but finite. And the same goes for the inputs. So for all combinations of programs and inputs that are shorter than this value max length here, we run a simulation for exactly max length steps. And if the program halts on the input after exactly max length steps, then we print the program and we print the input. If it hasn't halted yet, don't care, throw it away, wait until the next loop.